The reaction to nuclear has always fascinated me. It's not just how the cell reacts, but the body, the human, the mind. I was an undergraduate from 1982 to 1986, and I got my degree in radiological health sciences. 6 weeks before I graduated from Oregon State University, Chernobyl happened. And so Chernobyl really defined my first few years out of school. I had been commissioned in the U.S. Army, having gone through ROTC here at Oregon State. I was assigned over to Germany, and basically part of my portfolio was understanding the migration of radiation through the environment across Europe from the fallout of Chernobyl. That experience set me up for success when 25 years later, I'm at the White House, Fukushima has just happened, and they asked me to pull together kind of the technical response so that they could understand the technical underpinnings for their operational decisions there at the White House as we figured out what would be the best support to Japan. My dad, who had gone through ROTC, suggested I look into that. And so they got me from my freshman year. There was this small group on the campus, and they became my real true buddies. I mean, all the stuff I did in my extracurricular activities was with my ROTC battalion. And they had one thing that they had to do with all the cadets, and that was to train them to be leaders. And as an engineering student, that was exciting. Like, what's a leader? How do you train to be a leader? And at the end of those 4 years, I realized I had a skill set unlike most all graduates. A lot of students don't go into the STEM areas because they are afraid to fail, they're afraid to get poor grades, and they're afraid that those poor grades reflect on them as not being smart or capable or able. That's what college is for. It's to get in and do the hard things, to fail, to question, to not be successful. That's not your job. Your job as a student is to learn, period. And you learn through failure. You learn faster through failure than any other means, right? You will have teachers, faculty, coaches, supporters, cheerleaders who will get you through 4 years. But if you're not taking the hardest path through your education, you're wasting an opportunity. And the experience of doing hard things as an undergraduate will result in amazing futures. Don't be scared of that. I had almost 9 years at the White House. That was a highlight of my career.